I woke up at 2 o'clock this morning, so it's a beginning of the day. It's actually like 2:30 right now, and I was doing DoorDash late last night. On the weekends, the nights are like super busy, so I actually made bank last night. I was more successful just from like 12 o'clock last night to like 4 o'clock in the morning than like any other day this week. So it was really good. On the less positive side, I slept like all day, so I'm here now. Coffee shop closes in about 4 hours, but that should give me enough time to edit and upload a video. And then after that, I have no idea what we're doing today, but hopefully DoorDash, because then we can make more money. And on Monday, we can take the Jeep in to get fixed. What's up, guys? Sun's going down because I woke up at 2 p.m. so I'm gonna have to make this fast. Little bit of updates for you guys. In my last video, I mentioned that I want to move back into the Jeep ASAP, but it's kind of useless until I can actually drive it. To get that done, I have to get the brakes fixed. On Monday, I'm going in first thing in the morning, assuming I wake up first thing in the morning, gonna go get that fixed. Until then, though, I have to make money. So the weekends are the best time to make money because you go, you got DoorDash people, you know, people don't want to leave their homes, they're at home, they want food, and they have money, so they pay you to go deliver the food. DoorDash weekends are the best time to do DoorDash. Because of that, I am going to go do DoorDash right now. Yesterday I did it till about 3 o'clock in the morning until it wasn't busy. So if I do it starting now, I could probably do it for 8 hours straight. It'll probably be busy the whole time. I might be able to make more than $100 just today doing DoorDash. See how this goes. Crossing my fingers on it. Kind of chilly outside. I went into a place yesterday, looked at some Benchmades. It's about all they had there. They had some CRKTs, but mostly looking for a very high quality knife. Now that I don't have Kai with me, once I get back out, I want to be fully prepared to kind of do things the way I had imagined doing it. Having Kai definitely made things a little bit more difficult. Even simply going to collect firewood was a challenge because I couldn't walk away from camp without him freaking out. And so I would try to take him with me, but then having him on a leash and everything made me very tangled. I have almost hurt myself multiple times having him with me, trying to like, you know, control him at the same time trying to like collect firewood. It's always been a challenge having him around. There's a lot of stuff that went on in the backgrounds that you guys did not see. I wasn't able to simply just walk around and explore while I had him with me. So since I will not be having him with me while continuing the trip, I have a couple things I am going to try to accomplish. When I was a kid, I used to love just walking around, exploring forests, collecting wood, carving stuff, making stuff, different things like that. I want to get back into that. I guess it's called bushcrafting. As a kid, it was just called carving pointy sticks and making forts out of sticks and making anything else out of sticks. Making anything out of sticks. I loved carving stuff out of sticks. Probably used a $10 pocket knife, but you know, when you have a creative mind, you can do anything with a $10 pocket knife. I am looking into knives. Currently, the knife I'm looking at is an SA-3B, I think is what it's called. It looks like a very good knife. It's small. I might be able to use it for cooking, cutting potatoes, all this other things. And so that's the knife I am looking at right now. It seems like the best option for what I want. I want to be able to like do some light bushcrafting with it, you know, get into survival stuff. But then also just use it for like cooking and different things. It'd be really cool if I could get into like hunting, fishing, maybe even, you know, cook some fish that I catch. That would be really cool. I think Sean ended up doing that actually. Caught a catfish and scalloped it. You know, something that I can do all those things with one knife. That would be great. I would like to have a knife on me, especially while doing DoorDashes, just for self-defense and stuff. You know, something happens, someone goes crazy on me, someone, you know, I don't get their food right and they attack me, you know, pull out my knife and just, yeah, you know, something. I do have a taser. Maybe I should start carrying that around. Benchmades are very high quality folding knives. Sean let me borrow one of his for a while. Only thing is they're like $200, but they actually issue those in the military. So I definitely know those are high quality. However, having a fold-out knife. I'm not sure how well it would be used for carving things, like how I'm thinking. I don't think I'm going to be doing a batoning with this knife because I have my Kabar BK2, which is a great batoning knife because it's like this thick. I want something more just really small, what I was basically doing with it, slicing stuff. It's going to probably be a little bit heavier, but I'm going to carry it on my hip because every other knife I've had so far that I've lost, I have lost every other knife strictly because it was in my pocket and it fell out. So I think if I carry it on my hip, I won't have to worry about that happening again. 10 out of 10. Best explanation I can think of. I can't think of any other way to keep these knives safe because I'm losing knives back and forth. And if I invest in a knife, I do not want to lose it within a week. If anyone has any suggestions on knives, you know, let me know. Oh wait, I forgot. I don't read comments anymore. Never mind, don't let me know. Wait for a live stream. Let me know later. I like don't even read comments anymore for personal reasons. They might be obvious, but I just don't. Hopefully we're gonna get the Jeep fixed on Monday. I really hope that the brakes just need like vacuumed out or something, or I don't know. I really hope it's just like a loose screw somewhere. If it's not, it could be really expensive. But I have a lot of stuff I wanna order. I have a lot of things I wanna change. I really want to get back into what the channel's all about, living in the Jeep. I wanna get back to living in the Jeep. Even if I'm in Midland, I wanna live in the Jeep. So soon hopefully, that's what I'm hoping for. But for now, we gotta get to the means of getting that done, which is DoorDash. Make money to live in the Jeep.